Welcome to another Species Spotlight. Today we're going to be highlighting the Lignum Vitae tree. This is a native tree to the Florida Keys. It grows throughout Florida into the West Indies and the Caribbean Islands, in Mexico and into Central America. This tree is an evergreen. That means that it doesn't lose its leaves, it stays green year round. And it can be identified by looking at the leaves and the leaf shape. They have 1 to 2 inch long green leathery leaves. As you can see here, they grow in an opposite to sub-opposite pattern or arrangement. They're also easily identified by their beautiful flowers. If you recognize it, it's because it's actually the logo of the Key West Tropical Forest and Botanical Garden. So the flowers will bloom year-round, but they mostly bloom in the springtime, so we are seeing a lot of them right now. They grow in clusters and are small, bluish-purple flowers with yellow insides. Their job is to attract the bees and the butterflies that help to pollinate these flowers. Once the flower is done blooming, a berry will grow in its place. So they have yellow to orange berries that have 5 capsules that enclose the seeds. Whenever the capsules open up, inside you'll see a bright red seed, and that's the inside of that. So those are spread by birds that might eat the berries and then later poop it out, spread the seeds, have another tree grow. Something really cool about this plant, something really special about it, is it's wood, actually. So they have this between black to kind of a light gray or creamy white colored bark, that when it gets older that they will develop these patches. This is natural, this tree isn't diseased or anything like that. But the wood is extremely thick and dense and super heavy. So if you were to put this wood into water, it would actually sink, which is different than most woods. For that reason, it's been used a lot in propeller shafts and also even bowling balls. People used to make bowling balls out of Lignum Vitae wood because it's so heavy. The wood is extremely valuable, and because of this, it's been over-harvested. It's also been over-harvested because of its medicinal properties. So this tree helped aid people who had syphilis, who had Lyme's disease, who've had arthritis, the common cough, and even some skin conditions. So it's been over-harvested for all of those reasons, and currently it's actually listed as endangered. So these trees are more and more rare to see, and we hope that they eventually spread and are a common sight because they're so beautiful. They can grow up to 30 feet tall. Usually, however, they're going to stop at around 8 to 12 feet with the same spread. So their spread will be 8 to 12 feet as well. They are able to thrive in these tropical Caribbean conditions because they're extremely tolerant to drought, to salt, to alkaline soils, and to sandy soils, which are all important characteristics of living down here in the Florida Keys and throughout the Caribbean islands. Some names for this tree, so they're called the Hollywood tree. Of course, the Lignum Vitae is the most common name that you'll hear, the Hollywood tree, and then also the tree or the wood of life. And those names come from, of course, all of the medicinal properties that this tree has. Because of the super hard wood, the super dense hard wood that it has, it's resistant to a lot of funguses and also termites or any other kind of pests that might try to burrow into the wood. And then some fun facts about this tree. It's actually the national tree of the Bahamas and the national flower of Jamaica, on top of being the logo of the Key West Tropical Forest and Botanical Garden. So I hope you learned a lot, and I hope to see you guys next week.